The Axe FX3 can hold up to 512 presets, but have you noticed that for each preset there's 8 scenes? What's a scene, and how does it differ from a preset? That's a tricky question to answer easily, but try to look at it like this. The FX3 comes stocked with a bunch of amps, cabinets, and pedals. You aren't limited to just one of anything in a preset. You build your presets using blocks. Blocks use channels, which are like storage areas. An amp block has 4 channels. Each channel holds 1 amp, so you can have 4 different amps per block, each with different settings. A cab block has 4 channels, with up to 4 different cabinets per channel, for a total of 16 cabinets per cab block, and so on. We'll go into blocks in depth in another video. An FX preset is kind of like a huge pedal board with a bunch of different pedals and a switcher with access to many different amps and cabs. But you can't use all of that stuff at the same time, so you use different amps, pedals, and cabs depending on the song or whether you're playing lead, etc. Okay, now think of those different settings as scenes. You can have a crunch scene, then a crank scene followed by a drive scene, a lead FX scene, a rotary scene, a dry crunch scene, a dry dark scene, then a dry crank scene. And instead of having to act like a ballerina and tap dance through your pedals, you just save each particular setup for easy recall later. Like I said, the FX3 can hold 512 presets with 8 scenes per preset for a total of 4,096 different combinations. The new Mark II version of the FX3 has double the memory, so it can hold 8,192 different combinations. So how do you access the scenes in each preset? Well, you can use the up and down buttons on the front panel to toggle through each scene on the front panel, or you can use Axe Edit 3 and click through the various scenes. You can also toggle through the scenes using a foot controller. The FX3 also allows you to specify which scene to use as the default in each preset. In other words, preset 1 can start with scene 1, preset 2 can start with scene 2, preset 3 can start with scene 8, etc. You don't have to land on scene 1 when you switch to a different preset. Each scene can be named independently. Look at the very first preset, 59 Bass Guy. If you've updated to the most recent firmware and presets, you'll see that you have 8 scenes in that preset. Crunch, Cranked, Drive, Lead FX, Rotary, Dry Crunch, Dry Dark, and Dry Cranked. Let's look at each scene. Scene 1, Crunch. It uses 6 blocks, in 1 and out 1. And then the Amp 1 block is using a 1959 Fender Bassman in Channel A. The Cab 1 block is using Channel B, which has a 410 Bassman cab mic'd with a Shure SM57 dynamic mic, and another 4x10 Bassman cab mic'd with a Royer R121 ribbon mic. The Reverb 1 block is using Channel A, which has the Studio Reverb. Finally, we have the Real-Time Analyzer block. But you can see that it also has blocks for Compressor, Wah, Phase, Drive, Chorus, Pan Trim, Delay, and Rotary. But they're grayed out. I mean, that just means that they're basically turned off for this scene. Let's look at the rest of the scenes. Scene 2, Cranked. This scene uses Channel B in the amp block, which has a 59 Bassman with the drive turned up. Yes, you can have 4 of the same amp in each channel in the amp block with different settings for each one. They don't have to be different amps. It also uses Channel A in the cab block, which has a 4x10 Bassman cab mic'd with a Beyer Dynamic M160 double ribbon mic. It's using the same reverb and RTA block settings as Scene 1. Scene 3, Drive. This scene has the Drive 1 block turned on, and it's using the Keeley Bender fuzz in Channel A. The amp block is using Channel C, which is the Bassman with the drive not quite as high as Scene 2. It's using the same cab, reverb, and RTA block settings as Scene 2. Scene 4, Lead FX. The amp block is using Channel D, a 59 Bassman with slightly different settings than Channel C. It also has the Delay 1 block activated using a monotape delay in Channel A. It's using the same drive, cab, reverb, and RTA block settings as Scene 2. Scene 5, Rotary. The drive block is turned off. The amp block is using Channel A. The rotary block is activated using Channel A. It's using the same cab, reverb, and RTA block settings as Scene 2. Scene 6, Dry Crunch. The amp block is using Channel A and the cabinet block is using the same cabinet as Scene 2. The only other active blocks are RTA, in 1, and out 1. Scene 7, Dry Dark. This scene is the same as scene 6, except for using channel D in the amp block. Scene 8, dry cranked. This scene is the same as scene 6, except for using channel B in the amp block. As for all of the other unused blocks, well, the wah block gets activated in each scene when you have an expression pedal connected and routed correctly. The other blocks can get turned on independently by using the switches on a foot controller. You could also set them as active in a scene and then save the scene. So, you can see that there's a lot going on in this preset. There are some guys who could use just this preset in the 8 scenes all night and never need anything else. That one preset is the same as having 4 59 Bassman amp heads on stage, each set differently, plus 3 different Bassman cabs, all mic'd with different mics. It also has a drive pedal, a wah-wah, a rotary, Leslie pedal, a delay pedal, and reverb. Think how much stage space that would take. But all you have to do to use them is just turn on a scene with a foot switch or use the up and down buttons on the front panel. How easy is that? Next week I'll be building a preset with different scenes using AxEdit 3. You don't want to miss this, so make sure to subscribe and turn notifications on.